While the Huawei P20 Lite doesn't pack quite as many special features as the standard P20 flagship phone, you'll still find lots of great little tools buried away in that Emotion UI software. Here's a pick of some of our favourite features for our full tips and tricks guide. And don't forget, for everything else you could possibly want to know about the Huawei P20 Lite, as well as the rest of the Huawei P20 family and every other smartphone pretty much that hits the UK, give us a like and a subscribe and ding that notifications bell to be the first to know when we post stuff. Cheers. Now, one of the first things we say you should always do as soon as you get a new Huawei device is get that apps tray back. As you can see, right now there is no apps drawer down here at the bottom of the screen, which means all the apps are stuck away in a horrible cluttered fashion right there on your desktops. Oh, I hate it so much! Thankfully, the solution is quick and simple. Just tap settings, go to display, and in there you'll find home screen style. Give that a little tappy tap tap, and here you'll find the drawer option. Give that a little poke as well, and in a few seconds time, oh thank God we have an apps tray. So all of your apps are stuck away in there and now you can clear up your desktops and get them nice and clutter free. Great stuff. Now the Huawei P20 Lite ain't exactly the biggest smartphone we've used in recent times, but at almost 6 inches it's not quite compact either. You'll still struggle to reach all the way up to the top of the phone to drag down that notifications bar, ditto any apps that are up there, and so on. But thankfully Huawei has included a nifty one-handed mode to help out. All you need to do is drag your thumb across the navigation dock down at the bottom, either left or right, and as you can see it just shrinks the display down towards the bottom of the screen. Therefore it's much easier to use, drag down the notifications, all of your apps should work in this mode as well, so it's all grand, and all you have to do is tap in this little black border and things will return to normal. If you want to actually play around with these settings, they're buried away in the Smart Assistant section, as you can see here, one-handed UI, mini screen view. It's activated by default, but for whatever reason, if you don't like it, you can get rid of it with a quick tap there. And there's also a shift and keyboard function, which just shunts the keyboard to the left or right side as well, as long as you're using Huawei's own custom efforts. Now, as well you probably know, Huawei has shoved a fair few of its own apps away on the P20 Lite, clogging up your lovely storage. Some of them are actually genuinely useful, such as the phone clone. That's good if you've just got your handset, you want to copy over your apps and your messages from your old phone. All you need to do is download the phone clone app onto the old handset if it's not already a Huawei device, and then it just copies all that shiz over for you, nice and simple. We also really like the phone manager, which is pretty good. You can clean up your storage and your memory, you can see how much mobile data you've been using, you can block numbers, which is one of the best features on here, so if you get lots of PPI sellers, stuff like that, just block them with a quick tap there. Virus scan as well is good, it just makes sure your handset is clean of any bugs and other nasties, and you can also, for instance, quickly jump into your battery saver mode stuff as well when you need to in a pinch. Now, one little feature on Huawei phones that you might not know about is the quick call feature. If your phone is off, you can quickly activate a call with someone simply by holding down the volume button. You'll then feel a bit of a rumble and hear a prompt, and as you can see here, you can then just quickly say whichever person it is you want to call, say their name, and it will automatically dial them. Lovely stuff. Huawei has also bundled away a load of motion controls and gesture support, which you can find by going into settings and then diving into the Smart Assistant functionality. Right in here, you'll find motion controls. So for instance, if you're receiving a phone call in a meeting or some other inopportune moment, all you need to do is just flip over the device and that will mute the call. Alternatively, you can also pick it up and raise it to your ear in order to answer the call automatically. And one of the other handy options in here is the three-fingered screenshot. As you can see, you just need to activate that and then just drag three fingers down the phone and it will take a screenshot at any time. Lovely stuff. Now, of course, the Huawei P20 Lite has a rear-mounted fingerprint sensor, which is quick and convenient just for confirming your identity and getting into your handset. But if you dive into the settings and go to security and privacy, there is actually a face unlock feature in there. All you need to do is hit continue and allow the disclaimer. And basically, that front-facing camera will check out your gorgeous mug and just map out your features, and then from that point on, you'll be able to use it to directly unlock the handset without having to refer to the fingerprint sensor. So for instance, we just turn it on now, it recognized my face, and immediately we're into the desktops. And that's really, really handy if you happen to be wearing gloves, you've got sticky mitts, something like that, so you can't use that fingerprint sensor. Definitely a good feature to have. Now dive back into the Huawei P20 Lite security and privacy settings and you'll find a couple other features in there that are worth checking out. One of these is the file safe feature, which basically adds a layer of encryption to some of your more confidential or sensitive photos, videos and other bits. I'll say no more than that. But all you need to do is hit enable, select the internal storage, set your own password, and that will then encrypt any files that you select in order to keep prying eyes off them. You've also got this private space feature, which is quite nifty. Basically, use an alternative finger to your standard one, which you use to unlock the smartphone, and it will take you to a secondary alternative desktops, complete with your own various apps and files. So what you need to do is hit enable, and then you need to come up with a decent little private space password. Obviously, got to be different from your standard password, otherwise there's not much point to it, and it can't be a crap one like 123456. As you can see, descend and repeat sequence is forbidden because it's rubbish. So we're just going to come up with a quick and simple one. Just got to confirm it quickly and then you should be good to go. Now you can of course associate the fingerprint with it as well. So I'm going to use a different finger for this one compared to the standard one. So I'll just use my little middle finger here. Associate that bad boy and just keep on tapping it until it's registered. And then in the future, whenever you use that finger to sign in, you'll be into your private space instead. So now with private space set up, if I use my original finger to unlock the handset, I'm into my standard desktops. However, if we lock it again, and then if I use my middle finger to unlock the device, I will then instead be into my private space. And this is basically a whole different set of desktops, as you can see there. It's basically what you would get if you reset the device. As you see, I've lost my apps tree and everything. I've got all the default apps set up as standard. So it's a whole secondary desktop. It's very, very handy if you've got, for instance, kids who want to use your phone. You can just get it set up exactly how you want it for them to be using it. So you can have a completely different set of apps, completely different set of files and everything as well. Definitely a handy little feature to have. Now briefly earlier when we were showing you some of those more useful Huawei apps, we went to Phone Manager and we showed you the quick access to the battery functionality. You can of course access this directly through settings as well. If you go into settings and then tap battery, this takes you into the battery settings obviously. And from here you can access the likes of the power saving mode and the ultra power saving mode, which just really help out if you're down to say 5% battery life, you've got just the dregs of your juice remaining. All it does is basically culls some of the less essential features and just allows you to get the most out of that remaining juice. You can also toggle down the screen resolution, and if you hit optimize, this will show you exactly how you can get longer lasting battery life. So for instance, screen brightness is currently set to 100%. Stick that on auto, that'll save a bit of power. Get rid of any apps that are sucking juice in the background. Change your screen timeout, all that kind of stuff. So it offers lots of little tips and tricks on how to get longer battery life. Definitely worth checking out. And that in a nutshell is our full Huawei P20 Lite tips and tricks guide. Don't forget to give us a like and a subscribe and ding that notifications bell if you want to be the first to hear when our P20 Lite in-depth review goes live. Thanks for watching everyone, cheers.